If you want to learn today how to serve your app server under AWS Load Balancer, you are in the right place. Today, I'm going to show you how to create AWS Application Load Balancer and how to connect all of your app server under one domain address, so you can serve everything in one spot. Stay tuned, we are about to start, and feel free to follow for more amazing AWS tutorials. Hey guys, and welcome back. Today I'm going to show you basically how to connect those two Node.js servers that you see on the screen that are hosted on AWS EC2 Ubuntu instance. Okay, at the moment, in order to reach out to them, I need to basically go to their IP separately. Okay, I have two Node.js servers, and this is the way that I'm like reaching out to them. And this is the SSH console where is the app server is actually running. As you can see, the log that is printing. And today I'm gonna connect both of them to one load balancer. If you don't know how to launch your first Node.js app server, you can follow my YouTube video that I did about it. It's very simple, very straightforward. You guys gonna love it. Okay, so let's start. So if you have AWS, please open the AWS dashboard, go to EC2 dashboard, okay, and then scroll down until you see the load balancing topic. Okay, great, and press load balancers. At the moment, as you can see, I don't have any load balancer, so I'm going to create a new one so you can learn and do it with me. So AWS coming with three main load balancers, and they have also one that is very old, the classic one. This is application load balancer. It's working on the 7 layer. Okay, you have also network load balancer that is more on the 3 or 4 layer of the TCP/IP. And you have also gateway load balancer. I'm not gonna use this one, and also the classic one that you probably heard about it or familiar with it. Okay, I'm gonna choose the application load balancer, the one that like divided traffic with HTTP, HTTPS, and it's listening to port. If you wanna extend your knowledge or like understand what is load balancer and how it works, the application one, you can just read. It's very simple, guys. It's very straightforward. Just few click of a button and you guys have a load balancer that's working for you. So the application load balancer basically working by listening to HTTP or HTTPS requests. Okay, it can be any port you wanna put. Okay, but usually the common one is 80 or 443 for SSL HTTPS. I'm gonna name my load balancer. Okay, I'm gonna choose the default setting basically, so you guys don't need to do something crazy here. Okay, so you have the internet facing, and you have the internal. We're gonna use the internet because we wanna serve it public. We have option to choose the IP address type. I'm gonna use the default one. Here it's very important. Here we're telling the load balancer which network availability zone and also subnet we want the load balancer to map the traffic coming through him, okay? So as you can see, at the moment, I'm just opening my EC2 dashboard, so you can see my server and where they are basically hosted related to availability zone. Okay, so those are the availability zone that you guys wanna choose. And the, every availability zone have subnet that relate to him. So US East 1A and US East 1C. Are basically where my server are hosted. Okay, next one, we need to create a security group. If you guys already created, you can just attach. I'm gonna create a new security group so you guys also learn how to create security group, right? Yeah, I want you guys to learn new information. Okay, so security group basically telling your feature, what kind of traffic you are allowed and which port. Also, which type of traffic, TCP, UDP, SSH. I'm gonna open basically the port 80, TCP, HTTP, okay? And I'm gonna allow it from IP4 and also IP6 address. So it's basically open to the world. This is what it means. Okay, perfect. So we made the second step after creating the load balancer, we're creating the security group. Okay, as you can see, I have the default, I have the new load balancer, and I have the one that related to my Node.js app servers. Okay, so now after we're refreshing the combo box, we basically can see the new security group that just created, and we can remove the default one. Next thing, the way that application load balancer working is by attaching target group. Basically, we're listening to a port 80 in this example, and then we need to redirect the traffic to target group. This target group can be instance, it can be IP addresses, it can be lambda function, and also another application load balancer. At today's example, I'm gonna show you how to create target group that are hosting inside instances, my Node.js server basically. So we're naming our Node.js, and as you can see, my internal Node.js is working on port 3000, right? But the application load balancer is listening to port 80. So one of the great features that the AWS application load balancer giving you is that you can listen external to one port, and internal you can listen and send the traffic to a different port. So we are listening on port 80, and we transfer the traffic to port 3000. You can do any port that you want, basically the one that are not the generic one. And another great feature is the health check. Okay, health check is basically telling the load balancer if the server is healthy. It means that if it's alive, and if it's alive, it means that the load balancer can channel traffic to it. So you just need to set path or route that will tell your application load balancer where you need to do the check. So I'm setting the health route, and I'm also override the port 80, and I'm doing the port 3000 because this is where my server listening to. And those things are like a default, basically threshold that you can set and change it whatever you want. Okay, perfect. So we created our first target group, and now we're gonna basically include those two servers that I already have. Okay, we're gonna include it, and basically those two servers are gonna be attached now to the target group that we just created. So when the application load balancer will channel the traffic, it will channel the traffic to our target group, and the target group have inside two servers that are listening in port 3000. Okay, so as you can see at the moment, I have total two Node.js. You can put how many servers that you want. And now we have our target group attached. You can add another target group. The second target group can be Lambda or another EC2 instance. You can play with it whatever you want. You can also use this feature to make a load balancer, the AWS load balancer, to work even faster. Okay, I'm not at the moment using that. You can add tags. And this is a summary of what we are doing, and let's create our load balancer. That's it, perfect. So at the moment, the load balancer is still under provisioning. It means that if you're gonna reach out to the address, it's not gonna work. Okay, this is where you see the domain, the DNS name, the domain name. You can put it here. Okay, and as you can see, it's not working because the load balancer is initializing. Once it's done, the status is gonna be active. Then it means that it's working. Okay, this is the default setting that you can see. Here is our listener. We listen in port 80, and we channel the traffic to our basically target group. As you can see, you can add even more listener. I'm not gonna do it now, but it's something that you guys can do later. Here you can see monitoring the request. It's very useful once your app is in production. And you can also attach other services that AWS have, like AWS WAF, its web application firewall, or other configuration that you want, that it will work together with the load balancer we just created. I'm not gonna use it at the moment. Okay, let's refresh our setting. Let's see that it's active. Still not yet. Let's wait a few more seconds. Okay, now our load balancer is active. It's listening under port 80, okay, with the domain name that I copied earlier. Let's see our target. Okay. So the target now is, as you see, are healthy. They are working, both of them. Here are the checking that the application load balancer doing. They're telling him that he can channel traffic now to those instances. Okay, so let's now, again, if you guys don't know from where you're going to take the domain name, you can take the domain name from here. Okay, let's refresh. Just want to show you exactly what you need to see. Okay, and there you go. It's working, guys. Congratulations. You enter under your load balancer two different servers. Okay, as you can see, it's the same domain name, but it's bringing you back always something else, okay, by the AWS application load balancer algorithm. So both of them are LT. If you want, you guys, you can remove one of the instances or you can add one of them. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to show you what happened if one of the servers suddenly not working. Okay, so I shut down the Node.js, one of them, the Node.js server too. I shut down the app server. Okay, so basically it's not supposed to work. Let's go to health check. Health check is returned back unhealthy. So it means the load balancer not going to channel traffic. No matter how many refresh I'm going to do, it always will channel traffic to the one that is healthy. So this is one biggest advantage of working with load balancer. It's monitor your server. Okay, I basically relaunch my Node.js server on server number 2. Okay, let's wait for the health check to work. Okay, now it's healthy. And bam! Load balancer know already that it's working as a channel traffic to this server. How beautiful it is, guys. You set your first load balancer in AWS cloud. Very simple, very straightforward. Love you. That is all for today. Thank you guys for watching. Please like and subscribe for more amazing tutorial. And leave comment below if you have any question regarding AWS, AI, serverless, and if you want to learn more about AWS. Thank you and have a great day.